In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I'm your teacher Saima Tanuli with the civics lecture number 4. Today inshallah we will start second chapter. In that we have civics, the basic concerns. Family, a basic social institution. Now, what is a family? Open your books on page number 17. As we know, man was not born alone. Only a union of the first man, Adam, and the first woman, Eve, made this human population possible, of which we are a part. In its simplest form, family is the association, a man and a woman united with a purpose to live together permanently as husband and wife and the expected children. According to the definition or meaning, family is derived from famulus, meaning a servant. It is a Latin word, and here the concept of servant is a servant of a magician or a scholar. But when we generally talk about a servant, we take it as the people who are working for us. In some societies, like the ancient Arab and Greek societies, family servants and slaves were also admitted as members of the household. आपके जो मुलाजमीन थे उनको भी household का एक हिस्सा समझा जाता था. The definition further given by Professor R. M. McWheeler is, it is a group defined by sex relationship to provide for the procreation. Procreation means production of offsprings and upbringing of children. That is a family. Now we have different types and kinds of family, in which we have matriarchal family. Matre means mother, archia means rule. It is a family in which descent is the origin, is reckoned through a common female member, and authority is vested in the eldest living female member. This family system is now a thing of the past. Aapka ye jo family system hai, it is no more, jisme we have the head of the family as the female. But in some cases there might be, when there is no one or no male in the family, then in that case we have our eldest female family member who will be the head. Matriarchal means just like we have maternal, jo aapke mother ki side se honge, jaise nanihal hota hai, to matriarchal means mother or the mother head or the mother who is the head of the family. Patriarchal family, that is patria means father, archia means rule. That is, this is a kind of family in which a descent is traced to the male member and authority is vested in eldest living male member. Aapke jo sabse bade ghar ke mard honge, jo sabse bade honge, umar mein sabse zyada honge, wo head of the family honge, which is mostly we have this kind of family in Asia and in Pakistan as well. Patriarchal again means something related with your father side, jaise paternal grandparents hote hain, aapke dadihal hota hai, to ye difference aata hai paternal aur maternal ka. Then we have single family. A single family consists of a husband, his wife and their children. The children, as soon as they grow up and get married, are separated from the parent family unit and establish an independent family unit of their own. Single family system is now common in the world, kyunki wo jo ek concept tha joint family ka, wo khatam hota chala gaya. Now next is joint family. What is that? A joint family consists of a husband, a wife, their parents, their children, and in some cases their grandchildren also. They live under one roof. Income of all family members is pooled together, and the eldest members, the grandfather or the grandmother, have a right to spend it collectively on all members of the family. Joint family system, however, is breaking with modernizing trends in the global society. It was previously there, still it is in some parts of Asia, like in India and Pakistan. हम अभी भी जॉइंट फैमिली सिस्टम को पसंद करते हैं क्योंकि इसमें आपके साथ बहुत सारे लोग रहते भी हैं और आपके ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स होते हैं हु कैन लुक आफ्टर यू एंड दे आर मैनेजिंग द हाउस वेल एज कम्पेयर टू अदर फैमिली मेम्बर्स सो बट विद टाइम इट इज़ नॉट एनी मोर हमारी जो ग्लोबल वर्ल्ड एक तरह की इमर्ज हुई है सोसाइटी उसमें सिंगल फैमिली ज़्यादा आ रही है. Next is the monogamous. Mono means one, and monogamy is the most popular family system in the modern age. One man and one woman establish a family relation which is generally lifelong. It is just like the single family system, having one man and women as husband and wife, and then they will be living together and raising kids. Polygamous, poly means more than one. Poly literally means many marriages. An alternative name for this system is polygamy, meaning many wives. In a polygamous family, a husband takes in marriage more than one wife, and that is mostly common in Islamic or Muslim countries. Hamare yahan jo Muslim countries mein hai ye polygamous system, otherwise it is not very affordable and easy to maintain. Then we have a polyandrous. Polyandrous is a form of family now almost defunct. Defunct means dead, finished, in which one woman married more than one husband. Descent was traced not to the father but to the mother. Jahan se jo origin tha wo maa se liya jata tha, father se nahi, as she was having more than one husbands. This type had some traces even in the beginning of the 20th century in Tibet and some parts of South India. South India aur Tibet mein 20th century ki beginning mein aise kuch family types thi, but they are no more. So these were the family types. Now what are the functions of a family? We have different types of functions of the family, in which we have biological functions. This is on page number 18 of your book. One important factor which unites a man and a woman and impels them to join in a family unit is the mating impulse inherent in both sexes. Another instinct attached to it is the rearing of children and an otherwise arduous. Arduous means difficult task happily taken up by the mother and the father as a labor of love. So these are the biological stages which man is going through, and he has to take up certain roles in life. First he is as a father and a mother, then as a offspring, as a child, and as siblings, and then as different roles. So this is the demand, biological demand of a person when he gets mature enough that he gets married and then he raises kids. Sociological, family is the basic unit of society. Sabse pehle jo basic unit hamare paas aaya of society, that was family. Society gains all its treasure of knowledge and imparts it in an enriched form to posterity. Posterity is the future generation through the institutions of family. So family is a kind of an institution in which this posterity, jo aapki future generation hai, it nurtures aur isko knowledge aur bahut sari cheeze and experience milta hai. Next is political. It is generally said that the state is family writ large. Aapki jo state hai वो फैमिली रिट लार्ज ही है. जैसे मैंने बताया कि इंडिविजुअल के जो फोर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ लाइफ हैं वही आपकी स्टेट में आ जाते हैं, और वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट स्टेट इज़ अ मैग्नीफाइड फॉर्म ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल. सो स्टेट इज़ फैमिली रिट लार्ज. इट हैज़ ऑल्सो बीन सेड दैट फैमिली इज़ द प्रीमियल. प्रीमियल मीन्स अर्ली स्टेज और प्राइमरी यूनिट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी. सबसे पहले फैमिली बनी, फिर वो क्लैंस में आई, ट्राइब्स में आई, देन इनटू विलेजेस एंड टाउन्स एंड सिटीज़, और फिर आपकी वर्ल्ड बनती चली गई. वुड्रो विल्सन हैज़ कॉल्ड फैमिली द सीड बेड ऑफ ऑल लार्जर ग्रोथ्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. इट इज़ द सीड थ्रू विच दिस ग्रोथ ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स हैज़ टेकन प्लेस. सो इट हैज़ अ पोलिटिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑल्सो. आपकी जो फैमिली है उसकी एक पोलिटिकल बैकग्राउंड और उसकी पोलिटिकल रोल भी है. एजुकेशनल, सो वॉट इज़ दैट? प्लेटो सेट एजुकेशन बिगिन्स बिफोर बर्थ. इट इज़ सेट दैट अ चाइल्ड इन द वूम ऑफ हिज और हर ऑफ हर मदर स्टार्ट्स लर्निंग थिंग्स. जैसे जब मदर कंसीव करती हैं तो कहते हैं इफ़ द मदर इज़ रिसाइटिंग होली कुरान और डिफरेंट आयट्स, द चाइल्ड कैन लर्न देम एज वेल. इफ़ द मदर इन हर प्रेगनेंसी शी इज़ डूइंग मैथमेटिकल क्वेश्चंस, द चिल्ड्रन विल बी और द चाइल्ड डेट विल कम इन टू लाइफ ही विल बी वेरी इंटेलिजेंट एंड वेरी मच गुड इन मैथमेटिक्स. सो जो इंसान की बिगिनिंग है लाइफ की फ्रॉम द वूम ऑफ द मदर, दैट इज़ द टाइम ही स्टार्ट्स लर्निंग. और आपको पता है कि एजुकेशन इज़ अ नेवर एंडिंग प्रोसेस. इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम क्रेडल एंड एंड्स टिल ग्रेव. आपकी सारी ज़िंदगी आप खुद को एक्सपीरियंस करते हैं और एक्सपीरियंस सीखते हैं और एजुकेट करते हैं. Plato said education begins before birth. The greatest educator of mankind, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and acquire knowledge from cradle to grave. ये एक मुसलमान का अव्वलीन फ़र्ज़ है कि वो ख़ुद को एजुकेट करे, enlightened करे, aware करे. Education is the primary function a family should perform. Family is the first school for the child. He or she learns फ़र्स्ट लेसन्स ऑफ मोरेलिटी, इखलाकियात, ओबीडियंस, फरमाबदारी, कोऑपरेशन, तावन, गॉड फियरिंग, अल्लाह से डरना, तकवा, ह्यूमन लव, इंसानियत से मोहब्बत एंड अफेक्शन इन द फैमिली. दीज आर द इनफॉर्मल एजुकेशन विच यू लर्न फ्रॉम योर होम एंड फ्रॉम द लैप ऑफ योर मदर. शी टेल्स यू हाउ टू बिहेव विद एल्डर्स एंड हाउ टू इंटरेक्ट विद अदर फैमिली मेम्बर्स. School, colleges and universities impart arts and crafts and information. The real essence of humanity and conscience is transmitted to posterity. Posterity, मैंने आपको बताया, future generation. Only through the institution of family. ये family जो है हमें ये अपनी जो educate करती है, that starts from this informal education which you start gathering from your home when you are born. Or at the same time, formal education is which you acquire after getting admission in a certain institute. So the character or the personality of a child is built with two things, that is he, H, heredity, and E, environment. Now the next function of the family is economic. What that will be? In ancient economics, fully economic family served as the basic economic unit. Animal husbandry, when you are raising animals and you are having these livestock kya hote hain, jisme aapke paas bhed bakriyan hoti hain, gaaye hoti hain, and agriculture are the most primitive human occupations. Insaan ne jo sabse pehle occupation acquire ki thi, as he was very simple and did not have technology at that time, so he started agriculture first of all. That was the first primitive human occupation. Entire family of the herdsman and the cultivator participated in pursuits like rearing the cattle, tilling the soil and sowing and reaping the harvest. Hum kehte hain na, jo hum bote the wahi kaat rahe hote the. जैसे फसलें हैं, गंदम की हैं, अनाज की हैं. फर्स्ट इंडस्ट्रियल यूनिट्स फॉर एस्टेब्लिश विद इन द बाउंड्री वॉल्स ऑफ फैमिली अबॉड्स. अबॉड्स क्या होते हैं? अ हाउस और अ होम, एज कैन बी अंडरस्टूड फ्रॉम द टर्म कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री. इट वॉज द फर्स्ट प्रिमिटिव ऑक्यूपेशन ऑफ द मैन, जिसमें उसने लैंड को यूज़ किया फॉर कल्टीवेशन, और उसमें कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री, छोटी छोटी इंडस्ट्रीज इस्टेब्लिश हुई। अगेन कॉटेज इंडस्ट्रीज़ क्या हैं, वो छोटी छोटी इंडस्ट्रीज़ विच यू कैन सेट अप एट होम, लाइक मेकिंग ऑफ बैंगल्स, और पोटरी वर्क है, मिट्टी के बर्तन बना रहे हैं, या फिर एम्ब्रॉयडरी है। द टर्म इज़ इन कॉमन यूज़ इवन टूडे, ऑल्दो द फैमिली हैज़ लॉस्ट इट्स प्रिमिटिव रोल एज द सेंट्रल इकोनॉमिक इंस्टीट्यूशन, इट कॉन्टिन्यूज टू सर्व एज द नर्सरी वेयर द चाइल्ड लर्न्स हिज और हर फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ होम इकोनॉमिक्स। आपको आपके घर से ही द वैल्यू ऑफ वेल्थ और इकोनॉमिक्स का एक जो इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल है इन योर लाइफ, यू लर्न फ्रॉम योर होम। आप देखें, एट टाइम्स व्हेन यू आर स्मॉल, पेरेंट्स विल नॉट बी गिविंग यू एनी काइंड ऑफ मनी, बट व्हेन यू ग्रो अप दे स्टार्ट गिविंग यू पॉकेट मनी और मनी टू स्पेंड, सो दैट यू मस्ट हैव, वी कैन से यू मस्ट रियलाइज द इम्पॉर्टेंस एंड वैल्यू ऑफ मनी। सो फैमिली जो है उसके फंक्शंस में इकोनॉमिक फंक्शन भी बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करता है। एट द सेम टाइम इन अ फैमिली वट एवर द बजट वी विल बी हैविंग एट होम, जितना हमारे पास आमदनी होगी महीने की, जो भी फादर देते हैं मदर को, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट शी विल बी स्पेंडिंग द मनी। सो यू लर्न अबाउट how to spend your money and how to be economical and how to be moderate in life. Then we have psychological function of the family. Again, man is a thinking animal. This is the biggest difference between all living beings, that man is a thinking animal, he can think. Food and shelter are not the only things which make him happy. He wants psychological satisfaction and peace of mind. It is in the family structure that he feels protected, loved, sympathized and facilitated. कहते हैं कि इंसान ही इंसान के काम आता है और इंसान ही इंसान को मुश्किल से निकालता है। We cannot live alone. I have told you in one of the previous lectures that isolation or loneliness is only to Allah Almighty or for a beast. या तो अल्लाह अकेला रह सकता है या फिर कोई बहुत वहशी जानवर। अदरवाइज इंसान जो है ही नीड्स साइकोलॉजिकल असिस्टेंस, हेल्प एंड इंटरेक्शन विद अदर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, एज ही इज़ अ थिंकिंग एनिमल, और वी कैन से थिंकिंग लिविंग बीइंग। सो ही नीड्स टू हैव इंटरेक्शन इन विच ही कैन शो और एक्सप्रेस हिज इमोशंस, और ही कैन एक्सप्रेस हिज क्रिएटिविटी इन डिफरेंट थिंग्स। Now last is recreational, that is the recreational aspect of family. It is not possible for anyone or anybody to fulfill all his needs by himself. Everybody needs others' help to satisfy his needs and yet make enough time for rest, recreation and higher intellectual pursuits. The family works on the principle of division of labor, sharing of responsibilities and specialization of functions. In the family unit, each person performs his or her share of responsibilities. By this practice, everybody is facilitated and a lot of time is saved. So this is a division of labor. When you are working together as a family, hum kehte hain, when we are working in a organization, hum hamesha keh rahe hote hain, we are a family. This means that we are working together, we are sharing common ideas, we are sharing common things, so that makes us a family. So in a family also, everyone should be participating, everyone should be helping each other out, as man cannot survive alone. And dekhen, jab aapki mother aapko aapki basic necessities of life at home provide karti hai, to automatically you can work better, you can study, you can manage to go in time to your school and colleges. So it is not possible for you to do everything alone. So there should be a kind of a we can say coordination and cooperation between the family members, so that they should be able to take rest and have leisure time as well. Even in a college or institutes, we have only 5 days of working. 2 days are free for the teachers and for the students as well, so that they can be taking some time for rest and for further preparing themselves for the next 5 working days. Individual and community. Now, what is that? What is a community? Community, observes Bogardis, is a social group with some degree of we feelings and living in a given area. When we are living in an area, common area, and we are sharing we feelings, that is, that we consider as ourselves as a group of people living together, that is a community. And basically this community, as we can say also according to Obsborn and Neumer, a group of people living in contiguous geographical area. Contiguous are the areas in which they are sharing the common boundary, having common center of interest and activities, and functioning together in the chief concerns of life. So this is a community. It gives us a cement, or we can say it cements people together. Community mein jab aap rehte hain to aap ek dusre se jud jate hain, feeling of oneness aati hai. Community, according to MacLever, is an area of social living marked by some degree of social coherence. Again, social coherence, when you are socially intact with each other. A group of people living together in a particular area, sharing common ideas and beliefs or interest, that makes a community. Community has three basic elements, jisme a group of human beings hai. Second, living in a geographical contiguous area, that is geographically linked area, having common boundaries. And third, socially coherent, sharing interests and activities that are common. Community differentiated from other human associations. What is the difference between community and other associations like nationality or society? Community has we feelings. Community jo hai na, basically that has a we feeling. Aap ikatthe reh rahe ek jagah mein, aapki ek jaisi ideas hain aur interest hain. Whereas tribe, clan and family are ethnic entities which are different. They have their own ideologies, their own kind of thinkings. Permanent settlement on a definite territory is a prerequisite. Prerequisite means requirement of a community. Ek jagah mustaqil jab aap reh rahe hain territory mein, ye sabse badi demand hai of having a community life. Nationality has no such precondition attached with it. On the other hand, agar hum nationality dekhen, like we have this group of we can say Jews, they will be living in they are spread in almost all the 7 continents of the world and claim to be a nationality, but they cannot be termed as a community if the term is to be applied in its true sense. Nationality you had, that is different, in which you will be living in different parts of the world, but you will not claim to be a community. Now, what is this community's entity? It is non-political. Aapki jo community hogi na, it is non-political. It do not have any political essence in that. You don't have any kind of government in that, or any kind of, we can say, any kind of political government or political authority on you. It has a non-political entity or origin. Society is the highest and the most comprehensive of all human associations. Agar hum society ko dekhe, to society jo hai, it is most comprehensive of all human association. Society is a term which stands for the entire network of social relationship between individual or between groups and individuals. Community, on the other hand, only represents one center of interest, that is a place where these people will be having common interest and common ideas. So this is the topic for today, and inshallah in my next lecture we will be studying individual, nation and nationality. Keep on learning the definitions that are there so that you will not be have too much of work in the end. And the thought for today is sow virtue, reap honor. Do good things and in return God will give you honor. Thank you very much and have a nice day.